November 6, 2024, school board meeting to order, please. Invocation by Ms. Leslie Wells, District 8, and then the Pledge of Allegiance.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for allowing us to gather together this evening to faithfully serve you and our school district. Allow your holy wisdom to be upon us and guide us to make decisions according to your will. Watch over all employees and students and bless them endlessly for their unwavering dedication to our parish. We ask all of this in your holy name. Amen.
Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Item D, roll call.
Mr. Wright?
Here.
Dr. Gia? Ms. Babbitt?
Here.
Ms. Rotita?
Here.
Mr. Duplantis? Ms. Bourgeois?
Here.
Mr. LaFont?
Here.
Ms. Wells?
Here.
Ms. Sharpenshire?
Here.
We have a quorum.
Item number two, awards and recognition. A, introduce new administrators. Mr. Martin?
Yes, ma'am. It's my pleasure to introduce a new administrator. This is going to be a new assistant principal to South Lafourche High School, somebody who is not new to South Lafourche High School but new to this role, Ms. Erin Freelander.
Thank you for the opportunity, and I'm happy to be a Tarpon again.
Very good, very good. Congratulations, Ms. Freelander.
Yes, congratulations to you. B, Lafourche Parish School District student, staff, and group recognitions.
Welcome. It's our privilege tonight to be able to recognize all of our school winners for Student of the Year. So Student of the Year isn't just about test grades and LEAP scores. And while academic achievement is a big part of that, it's about leadership and character and service to your school and your community as well. So if you're sitting here tonight to be recognized for this, that means you're the total package. You're awesome. Okay, so it's our So we're gonna recognize each one of you individually. So we're gonna start with our high schools. Our high school winners, and then go to middle and then elementary school, and we'll call your name. You can come up if you're sitting on one of the second or third rows. You'll come around this way and receive your award from Mr. Martin and Ms. Bourgeois, and then you'll turn to me and I'll take a quick picture of you, and then you can go back to your seat this way. We're gonna do each category. So our high school will recognize all three winners, and then our overall winner for high school, and then we'll do the same for middle and elementary schools. Ms. Ann Hodson's is gonna announce each winner.
All right, I'm gonna start with the high schools. So from Central Lafourche High School, we have Blake Brabear.
Is it 24 hours?
Bayou Community Academy, Cruz Liret. From Golden Meadow Middle School, Caleb Meyer.
Well-rounded, right?
From La Rose Cutoff Middle School, Ava Plaisance. Lafourche Middle School, Bella Wiley. From Raceland Middle, Ava Martin. Middle School, Olivia Benoit. From Thibodeau Middle School, Anya Lawson. And our overall middle school winner is Caleb Meyer. Bayou Buff Elementary, Shay Petrie. From Bayou Community Academy, Scarlett Gary. Washington, Kinley Morbon. From Chack Bay Elementary, Tallulah Stevens. Cutoff Elementary, Lily Nguyen. from Galliano Elementary, Emma Gidry. From Golden Meadow Upper Elementary, Mason Dedal. From Lafourche Upper Elementary, Elijah Landry. From North LaRose Elementary, Mackenzie Spalding. From South LaRose Elementary, Bailey Adams. From St. Charles Elementary, Dalton Zammit. And our overall winner for elementary is Bailey Adams.
All right, how about another round of applause? Just a couple of things I want to say. These folks represent three grade bands. Each grade band has over 1,000 students in it. So what you see sitting before you here tonight is the less than 1% of our very best kids in each grade for each of those categories. So when you see how small of a group it is, and then recognizing the one out of all of them, it's really just a tremendous testament to how special this group of kids is, and how well they're doing in school, and how well-rounded they are. The kid who run out because he's missing his football game and everything else. So it's just wonderful to share in the joy and celebration, which is our very best and brightest kids. So we're very, very proud of all of you. And I hope you have a great night. If you did not get a fantastic picture, we do have a good backdrop in the lobby. You can take some photos with the kids, and Ms. Bolton will have these posted to both the assuming webpage and Facebook here in the next few hours. So she'll have a good high definition picture
tomorrow.
You can crop this ugly mug out of it. I promise you. Very proud of all of you. Thank y'all so much. You're welcome to stay, but I hear the restaurants in Thibodeau are open if you are so inclined. So thank y'all so much.
Approval of minutes and observances and proclamations. A, to approve minutes of regular board meeting held on October 2nd, 2024. I need a motion by Ms. Sharpenjet, seconded by Mr. LaFont. Any public comment? Any board comment? Hearing none, we can vote. Motion carries. Item B, to proclaim November 17th through the 23rd, 2024, as National Apprenticeship Week in conjunction with the Louisiana Workforce Commission. Moved by Ms. Petito, seconded by Ms. Babbitt. Any public comment? Any board comment? I just want to say I'm glad we are acknowledging this because the CMC has a wonderful apprenticeship. We can vote.
Item A, to accept the dental and vision insurance carriers, Dena Dental Plan, 2-year rate, and the Community Eye Care, 4-year rate, for 2025, as presented by Buddy Lede of Gallagher Benefit Services Incorporated.
Motion by Mr. LaFont, second by Ms. Wells. Any public comment? Any board comment? We can vote. Motion carries.
Item B, to award the only responsive and responsible bidder, AC Supply Incorporated, for refrigerants through the maintenance department on an as-needed basis. So moved.
Seconded by Mr. Wright. Any public comment? Any board comment? We can vote. And motion carries.
Item C, to recommend the purchase of Angel Tracks transportation camera equipment and software in the amount of $592,704.80. So moved.
Seconded by Ms. Wells. Any public comment? Any board comment?
I know it was talked about at the meeting. I missed the meeting, but I think you probably got to know what this software does. It's amazing.
It is camera equipment in the on the buses, all lots of different views than what we've had before. I don't know if Mr.
I can speak a little bit up on it. So each bus would be outfitted with 8 cameras. 4 interior, 4 exterior. One of the exterior is a backup camera with a monitor in front of the driver so that they can, we try to limit our backups, but some avenues or areas don't allow us to eliminate those backups. But so it'll also provide access for us remotely without actually having to go to a bus, pull out an SD card, put it in a computer, download footage. So we'll have the access to do it from our offices. So we'll be able to, investigative purposes and things like that, be able to
parents will have access to the GPS as well?
Say that again.
Will parents have access to the GPS?
Through the next item.
Okay.
Traversa.
Okay.
Yeah, this is just the camera system. Yes, ma'am.
So I just want to say that the presentations done by both this Angel Tracks and Traversa at the committee meetings were absolutely wonderful. I know I'm jumping the gun on the next one, but it's a cost, but it's a huge investment into the safety of our kids, so it's well worth it. So thank you very much for all the footwork on this. Appreciate it.
I think the importance is that what Ms. Chris said was safety and accountability.
Yes.
I mean, that's a big thing.
Peace of mind.
And if anybody would like to know more about it, like Ms. Patton said, the presentations were great. Go back and look at the committee meeting on YouTube, and you can definitely find out a lot of information. Any other board comment? We can vote. And motion carries.
Item D, to approve the purchase of Traversa Transportation Routing Software and Equipment by Tyler Technologies in the amount of $294,758. So moved.
Seconded by Ms. Petito. Any public comment? Any board comment?
Again, can we explain that? Because this is amazing software right here.
Yeah. So Traversa will provide us with obviously a routing component to more efficiently build our routes. I'm not convinced these routes just continue the way they are because that's just the way they've been. I'm not convinced that they're the most efficient, most effective. So this system will allow us to build based on criteria we enter into the system. If we want to limit certain stops or certain roads, those turn-by-turn navigations will be available for us. Not that our drivers need turn-by-turn directions, but the overall efficiency of our runs. It will also provide parents, through a parent app, the location of the bus, so that parents, it will help reduce the number of phone calls from parents inquiring, is the bus on its way, like the bus is running late, so they'll be able to pull up from the phone ETAs of the bus that their child is assigned to. So not every parent will have access to this. You know, if I live in a community and I have no student enrolled in a school, I won't have access to that. Like, it is assigned a child to a parent. The parent doesn't track the child, the parent tracks the bus, if that makes sense. So the routing component and building efficient and effective routing, and then our routes, and then parents being able to access real-time locations of their children. That those components will also show speeds and things like that, which I've stressed to our bus drivers. So when calls come in of speeding, there's going to be no more, well, I was or I wasn't. So. Again, accountability purposes, it'll hold our people accountable and provide parents with some sort of peace of mind of where my baby is at any moment. So it's a great product, and again, another one of those things that our department looks forward to utilizing.
Yes,
Ms. Arnold, can you explain what would happen if a bus is out of service and a backup bus is taking a route?
So if I'm a driver, and Ms. Fertitta is out, and I inherit Ms. Fertitta's route, there's a panel located on my dashboard where I can pick up her route. So when that happens, the parent also gets a notification or access to say, okay, I normally ride bus 50, but today I'm riding bus 70. Again, we'll still provide real-time locations, even though I'm riding a different bus for today, and I'm glad you brought that up. So. Whether I'm getting on this bus or this bus, parents will still be able to, there you go there. So parents will still be able to get ETAs on their children.
Thank you.
Yep, no problem.
Any other questions? I know if Mr. DePlanis was here, he would ask, and the funding source? So I'm going to ask him this.
So I'll take that one. Get the weight off Chris's back. That will be the general fund. And again, you can see that the
first year cost is high because you're purchasing the equipment, and then it falls down to a much more reasonable $60,000 a year subscription.
Thank you for that.
Any other discussion?
I just think you can't put a price on the safety.
I agree. We can vote. And the motion carries. Item number 5, approval of land and facilities management committee recommendations as per meeting held Wednesday, October 16, 2024. Ms. Fallon.
Item A, to approve a change order request to add 3 additional days to the contract at St. Charles Elementary School due to inclement weather. So moved.
Seconded by Ms. Fertitta. Any public comment? Any board comment? Just 3 days, Ms. Fallon. We can vote. Motion carries.
Item B, to approve option number 2, as presented by Mr. Andy Positary, to enlarge a proposed new school building at Bayou Buff Elementary School to accommodate for a library space. So moved.
Seconded by Mr. LaFont. Any public comment? Any board comment? Hearing none, we can vote. Motion carries.
Item C, to approve a low bid for Hurricane Ida demolition of Bayou Buff Elementary School in the sum of $384,292. So moved.
Seconded by Ms. Wells. Excuse me. Any public comment? Any board comment? Yes, sir. Mr. LaFont?
I made this known at the committee meeting, and I just want to make it known again. And I know it's state law, but I think it's ridiculous that we have to pay architectural fees to knock down a building. Architects are supposed to build buildings. We don't need architects that hire 2 bulldozers to knock down a building. And I just think it's a waste of money, and I'm going to talk to our legislature about changing the law. I just think it's ridiculous. I think it is. That's nothing against the architect.
Right.
I'm not going after him personally. I'm just going at after
the law.
The system.
Yes, ma'am.
And of course, the Little Red Schoolhouse is going to remain.
Oh, yes. It will remain in its current location.
Yeah. That is the oldest school building in Lafourche County.
Yes. And they'll do some remodeling, a little bit of it.
Yes, and the annex building, that newer building in the back.
Yeah.
So that and the Red School building will be staying
there.
Any other board comment? Hearing none, we can vote. And the motion carries.
Item D, to approve a lease of land agreement by and between the Lafourche Parish School Board and Edie White Catholic High School, and allow the superintendent to execute said contract on behalf of the Lafourche Parish School Board. Before I motion this, I just want to say thank you to everybody. I was the one that was kind of on the stick about this one, and I had to have my feelings known. But thank y'all very much for listening, and thank you to Edie White as well for hearing me out. So moved.
I'll second that. Any public comment? Any board comment? Yes, sir.
I just wanted to say that reading through the lease, I think it gives us this the district all the protections we need to make sure that we maintain the green space as it's supposed to be. Otherwise, I don't think any of us would vote for it, but it does give that protection.
Agrees. I think we have come to an agreement that satisfies our needs, Edie White's needs, and the needs of the neighbors, which I think are really important. So we're considering all aspects, and I think we've come to something that is going to be pleasing to everybody.
Yes, it seems to be a win-win for everybody. Any other board comment? Hearing none, we can vote. And the
and motion carries. Item E, to approve a request from Thibodeau Express Basketball to waive all fees associated with the rental of the school gyms in the area for 3-year period through 2027. The requester would be responsible for the $300 damage deposit per school and custodian fees. So moved.
Second by Mr. Wright. Any public comment? Any board comment?
Yes, I do want to say something. I see two of the coaches up there, and I just want to thank them. Our grandson's been involved with the Thibodeau Express, and they do a remarkable job with some of our students that we might lose if they didn't get involved in something like that. And they have to maintain a certain grade point average. If they get in trouble at school, they get in trouble at the basketball court, and they really are doing a remarkable job of keeping our students busy and teaching them manners and teaching them responsibility. And I want to thank those gentlemen that are out there.
Thank you very much. That's awesome. We appreciate anybody that helps out our students.
Couldn't do it without y'all.
Any other comment? Hearing none, we can vote. And the motion carries. Good job, coaches.
Item F, to approve a request from Club 1273 for a Christmas production to waive the fees for the use of the auditorium at South Lafourche High School. The requester would be responsible for the $300 damage deposit and custodial fees. So moved.
Second by Mr. LaFont. Any public comment? Any board comment? Yes, ma'am.
I know Mr. Ripsack's here with us. I know him personally. I know he's done a tremendous job in starting this club and getting a lot of the students from Golden Meadow to LaRose involved in the arts after school. And they've been going strong for a little while now. And it's really nice to see their program growing. And it's my pleasure to be able to help them by allowing them to use South Lafourche High School for this. So I'm going to vote yes.
Any other board comment? I said this at the committee meeting, and I'll say it again. I appreciate that it's theater and the arts. And, you know, we do a lot of requests for athletics, but it's nice that we have another outlet for our students also. So thank you for that. Hearing no other comments, we can vote. And motion carries. Thank you.
Item G, to approve the high bid in the amount of $1,001 annually from Chase Fonseca and Ryan Carbondale for hunting privileges on Section 27 and 33 Township 16 South, Range 21 East, which is the Lake Salvador area. So moved.
Seconded by Ms. Wells. Any public comment? Any board comment? We can vote. Motion carries.
Item H, to approve a low bid for the hurricane asbestos abatement in the sum of $61,900 at Golden Meadow Middle School. So moved.
Second by Ms. Charlotte. Any public comment? Any board comment? Hearing none, we can vote. Motion carries.
Item I, to approve a change order request in the sum of a credit of $4,877 for insurance requirements at Graceland Upper Elementary School. So moved.
I'll second that. We all like credit. Any public comment? Any board comment? Hearing none, we can vote. This is an easy vote. And motion carries.
Item J, to approve a request to hire Duplantis Design Group, PC, or BDG, for the hurricane auto repairs at Bonny Blue Middle School Gymnasium in the sum of $421,025.
I make a motion.
Mr. Wright makes the motion, seconded by Ms. Wells. Any public comment? Any board comment? Are you abstaining?
Yes.
Yeah, I think so.
After you.
Okay. All right, hearing none, we can vote. And motion carries with one abstaining.
My abstaining vote is due to potential conflict. Item K, to approve a request to hire Castos Goodwin Utley Engineers for the Hurricane Francine Bonny Blue Middle School Boiler Replacement Project in the sum of $272,954. So moved.
Seconded by Ms. Fertitta. Any public comment? Any board comment? Yes, sir.
I'm just glad to see our land facilities, this is getting shorter.
Yes, yes.
It's nice.
That is nice. Hearing none other, we can vote. And the motion carries.
Thank you.
Item number six, memorial resolutions. A, Mr. Dale Boudreaux, retired bus driver. Mr. Dale Boudreaux was hired by the Lafourche Parish School District on August 23, 1984 as a bus driver. Mr. Boudreaux retired on August 7, 1998, serving the Lafourche Parish School District for 14 years. Item B, Ms. Lucille Clemon, retired teacher's aide. Ms. Nakin.
Ms. Lucille Clemon was hired by the Lafourche Parish School District on January 6, 1981 as a teacher's aide at South Thibodeau Elementary School. Ms. Clemon retired on June 1, 1991, serving the Lafourche Parish School District for 10 and a half years.
Yes, ma'am. I would just like to make a comment. Lucille was my sister, my oldest sister, and she lived to be 93 years old. She went to work after raising nine children. She had nine children, and her nest was empty, so she started working as a para, which she loved. But then in 10 and a half years later, her grandchildren started coming, and so she retired to help out with those. And she was a beautiful lady. If you needed a prayer request for anything, she would pray for you, and usually those prayers were answered. And she was a wonderful cook, made the best homemade bread.
Just I was like going to say, mama. She's the one that made the best bread.
She made the best bread, yes, she did. And she was truly a treasure to our family. She was our matriarch, and we definitely miss her.
Yes.
Item number C, Ms. Mary Plaisance, retired teacher's aide, Mr. LaFont.
Ms. Mary Plaisance was hired on September 21st, 1992, as a teacher's aide at Lockport Lower Elementary. Ms. Plaisance retired on September 19, 2012, serving the Lafourche Parish School District for 20 years.
Oh, I'm sorry. I move that these resolutions be adopted by general consent and that a copy of the resolutions be recorded on a special page of our minute book.
With no objections, let the record reflect that these resolutions were adopted by general consent and will be recorded on a special page of our minute book. Item 7, tentative dates of future meetings. A, committee meetings, policy and academics committee, business committee, and land and facilities management committee, Wednesday, November 20th, 2024. And B, regular board meeting, Wednesday, December 4th, 2024. Before we adjourn, I just want to say a big congratulations to two of our local high school bands. Central Lafourche yesterday in Class 5C was awarded the state championship grand champions. And today, South Lafourche in Class 4C was awarded state champions, grand champions, so congratulations to both Central and South Central. Competed today and they came out fourth in the state. So big congratulations to them also. Oh, we also want to recognize our wonderful administrative assistant, Ms. Gwen Perkin Martinez. Sorry, Gwen. It was her birthday yesterday and we definitely appreciate her.